15, mm-hmm. and I was released 8 months ago. And during my time in prison, I ran across these words. It was in one prison that I ran across them, 2003. And they were powerful then, but it wasn't until I got transferred to another prison called Greater Ford that these words became so powerful and profound for me, because these creatures lived in that prison called Canadian geese. And they shared that space with us. Actually, they weren't trying to share the space with us. Again, it was an antagonistic relationship. You know what I'm saying? I mean, like, it was... But again, it was their space before the prison was built on it. Mm-hmm. Right? And it wasn't until I started reading Joel Kovel's books, well, his one book, Enemy of Nature, and where he was talking about dominative splitting, you know, separating ourselves from the rest of nature, the estrangement of ourselves from nature, and so on and so forth, that these words really, the gravity of them really started to settle on me. And there's five lessons from the geese. And the first lesson is this. Fact one. As each goose flaps its wings, it creates an uplift for the birds that follow. By flying in a V formation, the whole flock adds 71% greater flying range than if each bird flew alone. The lesson, people who share a common direction and sense of community can get where they're going quicker and easier because they're traveling on the thrust of one another. Fact two, when a goose falls out of formation, it suddenly feels the drag and resistance of flying alone. It quickly moves back into the formation to take advantage of the lifting power of the bird immediately in front of it. The lesson, if we have as much sense as a goose, we stay in formation with those heading where we want to go, we're willing to accept their help and offer our help to others. Fact three, when the lead goose tires, it rotates to the back of the formation and another goose flies to the point position. The lesson, it pays to take turns doing the hard tasks and sharing leadership. As with geese, people are interdependent on each other's skills, capabilities, and unique arrangements of gifts, talents, and resources. Fact four, the geese flying in formation honk, 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 we hear them, to encourage those up front to keep up their speed. The lesson, we need to make sure our honking is encouraging. In groups where there is encouragement, productivity is much greater. The power of encouragement, that is to stand by one's own heart and core values and encourage the heart and core values of others, is the quality of honking we seek. And fact five. When a goose gets sick, wounded, or shot down, two geese drop out of formation and follow it down to help and protect it. Who knew that? Right? They stay with it until it dies or is able to fly again. Then they launch out with another formation or catch up with the larger flock. The lesson, if we have as much sense as geese, we stand by each other in difficult times as well as when we are strong, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So we'll probably, hopefully, never look at Canadian geese the same again, right? Respect these creatures, because again, even when we were behind prison walls at Greater Ford, where the walls were like almost as tall as these trees, wow. where we couldn't even see trees and we were cut off from nature, we still were given something by nature to show us, you know, what it is to work together, to build a community, to keep families together, teams, run organizations, and just do what it takes to save our communities, save our family, right? Save our world. Because we can't do it without each other. And we are each other's only hope. And I think if we look deeply enough in Joel Kovel's work, we'll see that those seeds trapped in there. That's the message. And it's Joel's energy, you know, life, every life is an energy. And Joel's energy is producing this in this moment, us coming together. You know, and this is the example.
All right. Thank you. Thank you.